Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. My name is Miriam and I'm a full-time travel vlogger with my baby daughter Arella and my boyfriend Josh. In this video, I will explain and show you different ways how easily you can be vegan here in India and what we have been eating in India that's vegan. We have been traveling India for almost 3 months now and the food here is simply amazing and full of flavors. While traveling India, we have noticed that a large amount of people here are vegetarian. This has been really convenient to us and made everything much easier to buy, as most foods do not contain meat. Unfortunately, a lot of food products in India include large amounts of dairy. These products include milks, curd, butter and ghee. Luckily, most items are available as vegan options, therefore we are very grateful to everybody who were able to produce us a vegan meal with no problems at all. So how to be vegan in India? Let's start off with your normal shopping. Almost every city in India has at least a giant supermarket, which sells everyday food items like in any other supermarket across the world. Indian supermarkets sell a lot of legumes, ranging from chickpeas to different sort of beans, different rice options, and also soya chunks, which are great for protein. Of course, fruit and veggies are available at very low cost, which is amazing. Soya milk is largely available in different flavors. Some supermarkets also sell almond milk and coconut milk, but that's less common and usually harder to get, especially in the smaller cities. India has a large range of fruit and veggie markets everywhere. These sell many different veggie types and fruits at very low cost. But what about eating out? We love eating out as a family and trying new foods cooked by someone else. So the first thing we always do when we arrive to a new city is check a food application, which is called Happy Cow. If you didn't know what Happy Cow is, then it's an app that shows you vegan cafes and restaurants around the city, which is super helpful. After checking the app, we know exactly where the vegan places to eat are and we usually try to check them out if we have time. If there are no vegan specific places around, then that's never a problem. We look for local places that sell vegetarian food only, and while ordering our food, we try to explain to them that we do not eat dairy, ghee, curd, blah blah blah. Usually they understand what we mean. Sometimes there is a language barrier, but we never really have a problem in communicating our issue. Of course, sometimes the food would be sent back due to dairy being put in after long conversation about it, but that's just normal here in India. We also researched what food usually is made with dairy and which food we are able to eat. For example, rice and bread such as naan is of course vegan. And then we also eat curry such as aloo gobi, mixed vegetable, chana masala, etc. Indian is also very famous for its chai, which is a tea made with milk and sugar altogether mixed. We were shocked to find out that this tea is sold like that and already made, and we didn't get much option in deciding whether we want as black or with no sugar. That's just Indian tea and I think it's very unique. I just wish it was with soya milk instead. Luckily, sometimes we are able to find a local store that had an option for a black chai. Street food is also very popular in India and I'm pretty sure I have not really found any meat-based street food in India. Almost every single item is vegetarian here. Samosas, different street food curries, bread pakora and other famous street food items. This made it much easier to try street foods, as we know most are vegan, but again, before buying anything, we try to mention a non-vegan order and research few items before we buy anything. Plus, sugarcane juice is my new favorite drink. Tastes so delicious. Definitely try it if you haven't already. So these are my main tips how to be vegan in India. Are you a vegan and living in India? Let me know in the comments down below with your personal tips. Other than that, thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in my next video. If you have any questions, then please comment them down below. And yeah, thank you and I'll see you soon. Bye bye!